हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल कंप्लीट नॉलेज। हियर आई विल अपलोड वीडियोस फॉर इंजीनियरिंग एंड एमसीए स्टूडेंट व्हिच विल हेल्प इन देयर एकेडमिक्स एंड विल ट्राई टू कवर टॉपिक रिलेटेड टू योर सिलेबस। यू आर गोइंग टू एक्सपीरियंस इंटरेस्टिंग एंड यूनिक लर्निंग हियर। आई होप यू विल गेट योर ऑल द कंसेप्ट क्लियर विथ प्रैक्टिकल नॉलेज। सो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू माई चैनल। Now in today's lecture I will cover topic IP address. So first we will know about terms which I am going to use in this lecture, so that when we solve some problem later in this video you will come to know that what it is and why it is used. So we will come to know what is IP address, what is static IP address and dynamic IP address, what is network ID and broadcast ID, what is subnet mask, what is host ID, public IP and private IP address. So let's get started. So what is IP address and why it is used? IP address stands for Internet Protocol Address. It is a 32-bit logical address having 4 octet, each having value between 0 to 255. For example, 192.168.40.240. It helps to uniquely identify the PC or machine to send and receive packet. In similar way, our home address does to receive any post or parcel. With the help of IP address, we get data from the computer connected to internet. It comes to know on where, on which network packet need to be transferred to which PC, like that. You are able to see this YouTube video due to this IP address only. Mobile also has IP address, like computers. Server send data or file which we download. It can be audio or video. Based on this IP address, you are able to see this video on the mobile also. So now we will see what is static IP address and dynamic IP address. Static IP address, as the name says, it don't get changed. It is static. We need to configure it manually. As you can see in this picture, when we configure it manually like this, it is known as static IP address. Now when you enter IP config from CMD, you will get this address as IP address. So where static IP address used? Static IP address is used in routers and in server due to its static property. Now what is dynamic IP address? When we connect to internet, internet service provider provide IP address each time we connect to network or when network is getting refreshed. This is known as dynamic IP address. Static IP address are best for business which host their own website and provide internet services. Static IP address also work well when you have remote workers logging into work via a VPN. Dynamic IP address is best for its security purpose. With dynamic IP address, it's harder for a potential attacker to target your network equipment. Now we will see what is network ID and broadcast ID. Network ID is the portion of the IP address that identifies the TCP/IP network on which host resides. The network ID portion of an IP address uniquely identifies the host network on an internetwork, like the network within multiple networks, while the host ID portion of the IP address identifies the host within the network. Like we have streams such as BSc, BSc IT, BCom, in where students are there. BCom student belong to BCom network, BSc student belongs to BSc department or BSc stream. If we want to send some information to BSc student, we need to connect BSc department. Same as the concept of network ID. It provides the information about the particular network within the set of networks. Suppose we have two network, A and B. Network A range from 11.0.0.0 to 11.255.255.255, and network B range from 30.0.0 to 30.255.255.255, having in between host addresses of PC, as you can show in image. The address between network address and broadcast address can be assigned to host, and it is known as host address. Network ID and broadcast ID cannot be assigned to a host because it have a special use, which we are going to see. Then network ID 11.0.0.0 helps to determine that the packet is for the host of network A. Suppose I want to send some data to PC. that is to PC2 suppose, and it have IP address as 11.0.0.3. Then from network ID 11.0.0, we can get to know that PC2 belongs to network A. Now what is broadcast ID? Suppose we want to know PC is properly connected or not, or it is communicated or not. Then we don't need to ping each PC of a network individually. We can use ping 11.255.255.255. It will ping to all PC connected to network. In simple term, we can broadcast or send information to all the PC connected to network. Now let's see what is subnet mask. As the name shows, subnetting means dividing large group into smaller group. Suppose we have a network for our college which have several PC connected, but for easy managing and security we create two network. For this network, one for science and one for commerce stream. Then this is called as subnetting. Suppose IP address for science stream have range from 192.168.2.0 to 192.168.2.127, and IP address for commerce stream have range from 192.168.2.128 to 192.168.2.252. Suppose a PC from science stream wants to send or get data from the internet, then the data will get transmitted from that PC to local router, then from local router to internet service provider, that is internet service provider router. Then from internet service provider, it will get transmitted to server. After that, it fetches the data from server. The data will get transmitted from server to internet service provider, that is internet service provider router. Then from internet service provider, it will get directed to your local router, and from local router to your machine, that is the host. With subnet mask, router get information that it means router get helps to determine the network ID where the host reside. That is, router get information about the network from which data has come and the network to which the data need to be sent, that is to the intended host. So let's look into the example. Suppose the IP address is 192.168.2.3 and subnet mask is 255.255.255.0 having default gateway as 192.168.2.254. Then after performing AND operation between IP address and subnet mask, we get network ID as 192.168.2.0, which help to determine the network. After we have learned some basic terms which are related to IP address, let's move into some information related to IP address classes and some problem that we will solve in some time. TCP/IP define 5 classes of IP addresses, class A, B, C, D and E. Each has a range of valid IP address. The value of first octet determines the class. IP address from first three class A, B and C can be used for host addresses. So class A have IP address range from 1.0.0.0 to 126.0.0.0, where range 127.0.0.0, which also belong to class A, is reserved for special purpose, which is known as loopback address. Class B have IP address range from 128.0.0.0 to 191.255.0.0. Class C have IP address range from 192.0.0.0 to 223.255.255.0. Class D have IP address range from 224.0.0.0 to 239.255.255.255. Class E have IP address range from 240.0.0.0 to 255.255.255.254. We don't use class D and class E IP address. Class D is used for multicast networking and class E is used for future and experimental use. As we learned earlier, what is network ID and host ID? So now let's see how we can find network ID and host ID of an IP address. For class A, first octet is used for network and remaining three octet is used for host. For class B, first and second octet is used for network and remaining is used for host. For class C, first three octet is used for network and remaining last octet is used for host. Network ID get represented with bit 1 and host ID get represented with bit 0. Now let's look into some problem to find network ID, broadcast ID, subnet mask and number of usable host. So suppose the IP address is 116.10.10.15. Then what is network ID? From first octet we can know it is class A IP address. In class A, first octet is used for network and remaining octet are used for host. Therefore, the network ID for this IP address which belongs to class A will be 116.0.0.0. Now let the IP address is 196.10.10.10. From first octet, we can know that it is class C IP address. In class C, first three octet is reserved for network and last octet is used for host. Therefore, the network ID for this IP address will be 196.10.10.0. Similarly, for IP address 151.10.10.10, which belongs to class B, the network ID will be 151.10.0.0. Because first two octet are for network and remaining two octet are for host. Now let's find out subnet mask of IP address 116.10.10.20. As it is class A IP address, from first octet we can know that it is class A IP address, in which first octet represent network and remaining three octet represent host. Therefore, representing first octet for network with 1 and remaining three octet of host with 0, we can get this binary representation, and from this binary to decimal representation we come to know that class A subnet mask will be 255.0.0.0. Similarly, for IP address 161.10.20.10, as it belongs to class B representing first 2 octet which belong to network with 1 and remaining 2 octet which belong to host with 0, the subnet mask for this class B IP address will be 255.255.0.0. Now let's look into private IP and public IP. Private IP is for personal network. Means you can use it for personal, like in which some computer are connected and communicate with each other. We need to purchase public IP, but we don't need to purchase private IP. Now let's look into problem that how many computer can be connected in one IP, as we buy one IP not a range. So let's take an example. Suppose the IP address is 151.10.20.30. Then subnet ID for this network will be 151.10.0.0 and broadcast ID will be 151.10.255.255 and number of usable host will be 2^16 - 2, that is 2^16 - 2, 65535 IP addresses. Because last two octet are for host, means 16 bit can be used for host in class B. Therefore, we calculate the number of usable host as 2^16 - 2. Why minus 2? Because 2 IP address in this is for network ID and broadcast ID that cannot be assigned to any host. Therefore, we will minus 2. And we will get the number of PC that can be connected is 65534. Similarly, for IP address 12.200.200.200, it is class A IP address in which first octet is for network and remaining 3 octet is for host, that is 24 bit can be used for host. As 24 bit is getting used for host, the number of usable host will be 2^24 - 2. Network ID will be 12.0.0.0. Broadcast ID will be 12.255.255.255. Because network ID and broadcast ID cannot be assigned to the host, we will get the final number of visible host as 2^24 - 2. Now I end this lecture here. I hope you found this lecture interesting and informative. Please subscribe and like my channel for new video which will help you in your academic and help you to gain a clear and complete knowledge. See you soon. Till then, take care. Goodbye.